Children, last period we have discussed how to locate a rational number on the number line. Okay, two figures we have drawn. Next, one locate 8 by 6 we did or not? 8 by 6.
We did.
So one more. Do you want to explain once more that 8 by 6? Is it clear, all of you?
Yes,
okay, so one more. Locate. Mute, all of you, mute your video audio. Locate 5 by 3 on the number line. 5 by 3 on the number line. So 5 by 3 lies between
1 and 2
between 1 and 2. 5 by 3 lies between 1 and 2. So we will draw number line 1 and 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1 we can write 3 by 3. 1 we will write 3 by 3. And to get 2, what can we write? 1, 1, 3 by 3. To get 2, we will write 6 by 3. 6 by 3 is 2, no? So this is 4 by 3. First point will be 4 by 3. 4 by 3, 5 by 3. Our question is to locate 5 by 3. So this is our answer. First of all, you have to find out where does that given rational number lie, in between which of the integers, and divide that region, that region between those two integers, into equal number. How much? What is the denominator? Here denominator is 3. So divide the area between 1 and 2 into 3 equal parts. Then you can do. It's simple it is. Okay. Now we are moving to the decimal expansion of rational numbers. Right? Decimal expansion of rational numbers. Decimal expansion of rational numbers. Decimal expansion of.
Ma'am, can you show that one more?
You want to see the previous one?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Decimal expansion of rational numbers. Decimal expansion of rational numbers. Decimal expansion of rational numbers. Okay, children, you try to find out the decimal expansion of 10 by 3 first. Find the decimal expansion of 10 by 3. All of you divide and find out the decimal expansion of 10 by 3. Divide and find out.
I'm 3.333,
etc. Because when we divide 10 by 3, 3, 9, 10, again 9, 10, 3, 3, 3, etc. Okay. So decimal expansion of 10 by 3 will be 3.3333, etc. One more question. Find the decimal expansion of 7 by 8. Decimal expansion of 7 by 8. Find decimal expansion of, yes.
Ma'am,
when we are writing, we should only write 3.33, right?
No, etc. There, no. It's not, it is repeating. The 3 is repeating. So you have to put etc. Okay.
Okay.
And after that, I'll explain what we have to do. Is just become, yes.
We can 0.875.
0.875. Okay. 0.875. Isha, I will explain what we will do when this integer is repeating. What we will do, that I will explain. Wait. Okay. Now you put a dotted. Okay. 3.333, etc. Next one is 7 divided by 8 equal to 0.875. Third one, 1 by 7. Find the decimal expansion of 1 by 7. Alvin, do it.
Do it. Yes, ma'am.
1 by 7, fine.
Yes, ma'am, doing.
Do it. Thinking. division.
Can you repeat the question?
Okay, I will show. 1 by 7. Isha, 7 by, you finished this 7 by 8, Isha? Got it? Now try this 1 by 7. Wait. Let others also finish. Tamanna and Vedya, switch on your video.
Finish.
Wait. Wait some more minute because others are doing. Suryadev, Edlio, Fadil. Albert. Okay, Ritvik. What's the decimal expansion of? One second. That. Page is not same. Okay, Ritvik, say what is the decimal expansion? 0.14.
0.14.
Then
285 bar.
285
bar.
Oh, after 5?
It continues.
No. After 5.
Seven.
So we will continue with our 1/7. Okay, the trick. You got it? 1/7.
Yes,
and say
0.142857 bar.
0.142857. Then this repeating 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 8, 5, 7, etc. These 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7. 6 integers are repeating here. Okay. So see, all of you look at the board. 10/3 is equal to 3.333, etc. That 3 is repeating again and again. But 7/8, after 3 digits, 8, 7, 5, after 3 digits, it ends. Okay, here there is no repetition. But 1/7, 6 digits are repeating. 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7. Again, 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7. It is again repeating. The 6 digits are repeating. Okay, we will check some more. All of you find 1/9. 1/9. Find 1/9. 1/9. 1/8. These two. 1/9 and 1/8. Try. One by five also. 1/5 is very simple. 1/5. These three also. 1/9, 1/8, 1/5. Find it. What is 1/9, Navaneet? Okay, now Anandita, one by eight. Okay, do it. Lynette, one by eight. Okay, do it. Adhikesh, you got it? 1/8?
Oh my God.
Yes, yes, say.
0.125.
Oh, Lynette, you also got the same?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 0.125. And 1/5 is symbol. 1/5 is?
0.2.
0.2. 1/5 is 0.2. Okay, see, so we here we have discussed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rational numbers and their decimal expansions. In these 6 decimal expansions, this 7/8 and 1/8 and 1/5, okay, these three, after some decimal expansion or after some decimal values, that their decimal expansion ends or terminates. The decimal expansion terminates. Okay, after some numbers, after some integers, decimal values, their decimal expansion terminates. Where in the case of 7/8, 1/8 and 1/5. These type of decimal expansions are known as terminating decimal expansions. What are they? Terminating decimal expansions. Because after some decimal values, their decimal expansion terminates. But in these other cases, 10/3, 1/7, 1/9, here, the digits are repeating again and again. In the case of this 3 is repeating. Here 1 is repeating. In this 1/7, 6, after 6 digits, the same numbers are repeating. Okay. They are not terminates. They are non-terminating. Non-terminating. Non-terminating decimal expansions. So for a rational number, their expansion, the decimal expansions has only two types. One is terminating decimal expansion, other one is non-terminating decimal expansion. Okay, so the decimal expansion of rational numbers are of two types. The decimal expansion of rational numbers are of two types. One is terminating decimal expansion, other one is non-terminating decimal expansion. Terminating expansion means after some decimal values, their decimal expansion will terminate. That is, remainder becomes zero, isn't it? The decimal values become terminates means the remainder becomes zero. Okay, but in the other case, the decimal values are repeating. They are repeating. Okay, in the case of 1/7, after 6 digits, the numbers are repeating. So it is non-terminating decimal expansion. And such cases, remainder never becomes zero. Okay, so write these two points, children. Consider, right after this, write consider 7/8 equal to 0.875 and 1/8 equal to 0.125 and 1/5 equal to 0.2. In all these cases, right. In all these cases, the decimal expansion terminates. The decimal expansion terminates. The decimal expansion terminates after some steps. The decimal expansion terminates after some steps. Or the remainder became zero. Or the remainder became zero, zero after some steps. Underline that zero. Terminates also. Both words you underline. The remainder became zero after some steps.
Ma'am, can you repeat?
Okay, sure. In all these cases, the decimal expansion terminates. In all these cases, we can find many such cases. In all these cases, the decimal expansion terminates after some steps. Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Or the remainder became zero. Remainder became zero after some steps. Okay, right? The decimal expansion of such rational numbers are called, the decimal expansion of such rational numbers are called, the decimal expansion of such rational numbers are called terminating rational numbers. Terminating rational numbers. Terminating rational numbers. The decimal expansion of such rational numbers are called terminating rational numbers. Terminating rational numbers. Okay, children, our time is up. Okay. And from those number line depicting number rational numbers on number line, I will send some homework for the next day. Okay, children, bye, all of you. Bye, see you later.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.